We now know the name of the man shot, his name, Maurice Grant, and intentions are high here in this community because you have that classic case of what police were saying happened versus what the community is saying happened. Police were saying that a weapon was recovered on the scene and that Grant actually pointed that weapon at the officers before they fired at him. The community says something else entirely. They don't believe he had a weapon at all, and they say he was running away when he was shot in the back. That back and forth really raising the tensions here in this community. Someone I spoke with a short time ago actually telling me that they don't believe that Granton was involved in drugs at all when it comes to dealing with them at all, though this was a narcotics investigation. Now, the gunshot took his life, and now an investigation is underway. It was part of a narcotics case that took a violent turn. Police say the suspect ran away. They chased him, and he brandished a weapon. That's when an officer fired his gun, striking the offender. He was taken to the University of Chicago Trauma Center. He later died from his injuries. The officer was not shot, but he may have a broken ankle at this time. Meanwhile, police had to deal with angry residents because of perceived differences in what happened leading up to that shooting. A use of force investigation is underway by the Civilian Office of Police Accountability. Due to that, the officer who fired that shot is on 30 days administrative leave for now, serving desk duty, and they will until the investigation is wrapped up on what exactly happened here. We'll be sure to keep you posted on the latest on this investigation. For now, I'm live from Bronzeville, Brandon Pope, The Jam.